Jubi Show.
Oy vey.
Hello.
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 How's our length, our cord length, corn length today?
I'm all right. I'm not feeling the restrictions I did last week. How about yourself?
I feel much better.
Much better.
What's
good,
my
good.
Seat
much
doing
better.
Here? Hold on a minute.
I will.
I will find out. Oh, it's not doing much.
It was too low, right?
It was a notch too low. One
low.
Low rider
is a mean fighter.
Well, welcome to the Jubi Show this week.
Yeah.
On P-A-T-V.
Or P at V.
P at V.
You could say.
Patva.
You could say.
Yeah, P at V.
Patva, yes, I like that one too.
I've heard it called Pay TV before too.
Because you pay
to use it.
Yeah. It's corporate sponsorship at its finest.
Sorry if you're receiving ads on the TV during this broadcast.
It's entirely intentional.
Yep. We're running out of... The Jubi Show is running out of funds.
Running out of funds. We need everyone's money, and so we're getting it from everyone.
From you, we've gotten it already.
Yeah, from you, you don't know. This is just...
I'm going to open up a water here, because I have a feeling if I have anything to do with this show, it's going to be a wild one tonight.
It's going to be a wild one tonight.
If I have anything to do with
you,
it.
If you have anything to do... What does that have to do with opening up your deja blue?
Well, I'm going to need the water, because things are going to just be so... I'm probably gonna need a drink of water.
To wet my palate. Yes, to wet your palate and get you feeling artsy fartsy crafts.
You wanna know what's kind of weird and kooky, maybe a little? Is here, I'll tell you. I'll let you in on a secret. In the wino business.
The wino business.
You know, the ones who get a glass and they shake up the wine
and then
smell it a little and sniff it and spray a little on them just to get the feel for it.
Yes.
Those people say that they will often eat something in between the drinks, like
cleanse.
Yes, like an oyster cracker, which are not made of oysters. You know,
that's like a show in itself, though. Well, but yeah.
I'm just thinking it's weird that why would you need to cleanse your palate when your palate is the roof of your mouth, not something that is doing the wine tasting for you. Do you know? Do you see what I mean?
Is that right? I mean, the palate is that. By definition, just the top of your mouth.
Well, unless they're talking about their artist's painterly palate.
They're not, right? They're just talking about their mouth.
I'm not into the wine culture.
I can't stand wine. It gives me a headache, so I'm not going to be drinking it. But
if I drink too much wine, it gives me a headache.
I don't like the taste, and it gives me an instant headache. Well, red wine especially.
That's you liked common. That. You liked common. That. Lucio Rose that we had when we made that food there, right?
I did like that. That was some years ago, but yes, I did like that.
Maybe you've grown out of it.
You never know. People's taste buds develop and fall off.
People's palates bend and buckle.
Get new colors.
Yep.
New flavors, new varieties of color.
That's right. What was my point with all of this? Oh, I was just going to say the thing about the palate. But also, isn't that weird that they're oyster crackers? I'm sorry.
Oyster crackers. But we're not talking about, we're saving that for another show. Because we have...
Are we?
Yeah, you said that's okay. A topic for another... Those are your
words. Well, I said that. I don't remember my exact words, and I'll thank you not to twist them around if I didn't say that.
Oh, shit. Somebody's got this... I love it when the studio's all screwed up.
I hear lots of music from the other room. It's like a rave out there.
Yes. Yes, it is.
You can't do anything about...
I got it.
Okay. I thought they'd somehow bypassed the laws of physics made it impossible for you to fix.
I'm always surprised at the new things they can find to do to the studio and the control room to make things difficult. The royal they.
What would that even mean? You people at home. Is that what that means?
I have no idea.
Okay.
I have no idea. God, things are so... Well, if you think the Jubi show is weird, try the rest of the building.
We really need to produce that reality show.
I know, somebody does. I feel like so much is wasted.
It's ripe. It's ripe for picking.
Like, you watch stuff on True TV. I watch stuff on True TV. It seems pretty outrageous, pretty unbelievable, but God, if you could just get the shenanigans that go on video, it would be disturbing. But it would be some killer TV. People would eat that up.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And I can tell you, it's pretty low-hanging fruit, if you know what I'm saying. It's you don't have to look hard to find it.
Right. Yeah. These are... Yes. These are things that are being presented. Things. Events. People. Conversations. Being put out there. They're not private. This is a public building, so... Somebody should be videotaping
a public building with many video cameras.
Yeah, I know. I've thought about it many times how we should have, but we would have to have like sound gear. The whole place would have to be mic'd, you know, to pick up conversations and stuff from any angle.
That's true, but I mean,
but
you know, when they do a show like I'm assuming
a reality
like Big Brother
show.
Or something.
Never
I don't know
that.
If they
I don't even know what that is.
I don't either. I think people live in a house together.
Okay.
And there are cameras. But I don't know if they wear their own mics. Like that's the thing. Like do you need people to be wearing their own wireless mics in order to get good sound in a show like that?
Not always, like
you
on,
get a boom operator.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you need somebody. That's what you need. You need somebody running around following the action with a boom mic. That's what
Which,
you need.
Which for this particular establishment would involve standing in the middle of a room and spinning in a circle.
Well, you'd have to do some running in and out. There's a lot of parking lot action.
That's true, and there's a lot of distance between the lobby and the bathroom too.
Yes, there is. There's a lot of footwork going back and forth from the lobby and the bathroom.
You need a friend that was particularly athletic who could chase around after you.
Jared likes to run around the building. Maybe he could do it.
We should try to get Jared to do this.
PATV real.
Yeah, I was thinking PATV raw, but
raw,
PATV
but real.
Raw but real.
Raw but real. PATV raw but real. Real raw.
Real raw.
PATV real
Rubbed
raw.
Rubbed and raw.
Rubbed and raw. Cankered and sore.
Punctured and pussy.
Yeah.
Is that a little...
Well,
a little too tame.
If it's punctured, then the pus is probably draining, yeah?
Punctured and draining.
Yeah. PATV, punctured and draining. Watch it.
Watch it.
Only on True TV.
If you are the producer for True TV...
And I know you are.
And I know you are because you're watching this show.
Yeah.
Give us... you know how to find us because you're in the TV biz. Send us a letter and tell us that you want in on a piece of this action. We will set you up with something pretty sweet, which is a pretty large cut of the money you're going to pay us.
You're going to pay us so much money, you wouldn't believe. You're actually making out really well in this deal because...
You barely even have to do any work.
Yeah. You just make it, yeah.
What, I mean, I guess I'm not even clear on what they would even be doing here. Are we just trying to get the show aired? Are we negotiating our contract for that show on their network? Is that what we're doing right now?
Well,
Where do they sign?
If I understand correctly, we are fundraising all night long, every night, from now till eternity.
But True TV is the ones that are paying us, right? Is that what I'm
hopefully getting? They're our newest clients. They're our newest prospective clients.
Okay.
They're going to fund a whole new reality series.
PATV punctured and swollen. Or
Punctured and draining. Or, I mean, I liked...
Raw, real,
whatever it was. Yeah.
We'll go back to the tape. We'll figure. Don't worry about it. We'll figure it out. We've got it down.
We'll fix it in post. I have a whole long list of things to talk about.
Gosh, I'm sorry. We were on just such a roll there. I know. I was getting genuinely worked up there.
Yeah. Well, you know.
Worked up there.
Can I tell you honestly?
Yes.
Sometimes, and this might not even be polite. This might not be couth.
Okay.
Sometimes I fear for my personal safety hanging around.
Around me?
Not around you.
Yeah.
Around you, but
I can see that.
I mean,
raw but real.
It's really raw and real. Real and raw.
It's a...
Don't you ever feel fear for your personal safety at your job? I bet you do.
Yeah, I do, actually, sometimes.
Yeah.
People are like, why don't you have this thing? I found it here yesterday.
I guess it's just part of working and, like, having human beings around the vicinity. You're going to be afraid.
I have an inkling that I'm normal, kind of. I mean, I'm pretty weird, but I'm not, like,
crazy. Well, it's risky to define yourself as normal, but...
Well, yeah.
But there are certainly... Yeah, there's a spectrum, I would say.
It's like... It's like on the far normal end, I find myself. And my friends. And then on the other end is most other people.
Wow. How did you manage to meet all the normal ones?
You have no idea. Oh, I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, you're going.
No, I was about somewhere. I was about to change the topic.
Well, I was just going to I was going to segue from this cuz it kind of fits in with one of these items on the list.
But it kind of also segues into the thing that I was going to say, so I don't know.
So go ahead, just say it.
Okay. I was going to say that we may never know reminded me that it's October.
Yeah. Is it 10-4,
Big Daddy.
10-4, good buddy. Yes. What's your handle?
My handle is... Here's what we call the handle in the biz. My handle is that we have a Halloween episode coming up. We have a Halloween episode coming up, and it's been in production for 3 years now.
Okay.
We shot it in 2008. We've been working hard on it. We're finally... Well, we haven't really, to be honest, we haven't done much work on it lately.
We've actually been hardly working on it.
That's what I... So there's that. So
right. Look forward to that.
If not this year, next year maybe.
Yeah. Well,
I don't know.
I think
there's a lot of work to be done on it.
Oh, we're going that direction. I was gonna say I think it's still looking optimistic that we could get it done this year.
Oh, that's true.
But if not this year, definitely next
year.
Yeah.
Oh, it does look good. We are in a place where I feel we're ready to put something out there. I feel like we've got something to show people, finally.
Something spooky and fun.
Yeah, it's really fun.
Spooky and fun.
Brian's in it.
Yeah, Brian's in it even.
Yep.
That's fun.
Yeah, that's Brian's kind of spooky and fun.
Yeah, Brian's spooky and fun. Yeah.
Anyway, how is that segue into what you...
I don't...
We did it. We did. Hooray!
Segues into anything.
Was it not a good
about.
Segue? Did I ruin it? Well, hey, what were we talking about right before that? Let's try it again.
Okay, yeah, let's just pretend.
I mean, why not? This is TV. We can also always go back and change it.
We can fix it in post.
What were we saying? I remember, I said.
We might never know. We were just talking about having. Well, really, generally speaking, we were just talking about people, being around people, and how sometimes they scare you and freak you out.
Right.
That was going to segue into this thing. You know how last week.
Oh, gosh. That was a while ago.
Last week, on my walk to work, there was the whole deer in the throat singing.
Oh, you know,
that was the thing last week. This time, walking to work, I didn't have that experience, but I had kind of a funny experience anyway, because I was walking to work and it was real nice out, and the fall colors were real pretty. I was looking at all the trees, and then it's like, after I'm walking a while, sometimes I get some endorphins going and I'm starting to feel kind of happy. You know, exercise can make you feel a little happy sometimes. Yeah. So like, I'm feeling good, I'm in a pretty good mood, and I'm walking through Iowa City, and I passed this guy, construction working guy. He's crossing the street, kind of. I mean, we're just passing each other in the street, basically. He's an older man, wiry. Clearly, he's been doing hard work for a long time. He's smoking a cigarette. And as we pass each other, he looks me over and then stares me in the eye. And I give him a big friendly smile. Totally sincere, too, because I was feeling...
You feeling good.
He actually caught me in a friendly, happy moment. So I gave him a genuine smile, and he just looked away and cast his icy stare someplace else. And I thought that was really funny. It didn't hurt my feelings. I just thought it was really funny.
Did you laugh at the man?
No. Well, yes, I guess I kind of did, actually, now that you mentioned it. A little bit, just to myself, but... So I was smiling kind of because of that.
Right.
I was smiling as I continued to walk down the sidewalk. And what should happen, but I passed a young woman, quite young, I don't know how, I mean, probably late teens, very early 20s, but I'm glancing around. I glance at her and I see that she's looking at me, and I'm still smiling because I have never stopped smiling from
this
last encounter. Anyway, I see that she's looking at me, so I make eye contact with her, still smiling. Just the look of terror in her eyes.
That's really weird.
I don't know. It freaks people. I think this city is worse than a lot, but
it's weird. You know, there. You walk past a lot of people, and a lot of times people are just so eager to like look away.
People
are fun to look at. You should be able to look at people.
Yeah, why can't we just give each other a good looking over? That old construction man did it to me. It was fine.
Yeah. And he made his decision on what to do about it.
Best to just ignore it.
The other way. Yeah.
Yep. Anyway, I just think it's interesting how, and it's not like this is news. It's not new, but people in Iowa City, they're so unfriendly and antisocial. I'm not sure. It's something to do with the college. But.
You know what I hear a lot? I hear people say, I am from whatever state. And this is
Illinois.
I am from Illinois, and this place is just so friendly.
People say that?
People are so friendly. Yeah, I hear it all the time.
That's
like,
weird.
Back in Jersey.
I feel like almost every place I've ever visited, people have been friendlier than they are here. Which is not a huge complaint, because I don't really want to interact with people that much, but...
Have you ever been to Minnesota?
Yeah.
Some of those people are friendly.
I guess... No, this is not in the continental U.S. I was going to say in Canada they weren't very friendly, but that's Canada.
Same continent.
Yeah. It is the same continent.
Mm-hmm. They have some weird people up there, though.
But it's not the... I mean, it is the continental.
It's the continental. America. Yeah.
But it's not the U.S.
America.
It's not... Yeah. It is America. But we don't count them.
No, they're not counted.
They are not Americans.
They are not Americans.
French.
They may be French.
They're probably French
at work, at best.
Stupid. Oh, gosh.
A burp got me by the seat of my pants.
That sounds disgusting.
Better wash it down.
Speaking of burps, that reminds me of another list on this list. Another list on my list. It says flax and fish liver oil because...
Oh, yes.
Well, I just started taking those just last night. I started doing the flax and fish liver
oils. Are you getting
oils.
Your omega-3 fatty acids?
Yeah, because apparently I read right on Wikipedia that fish liver oil is used as a long-term remedy for multiple sclerosis. And can that... I don't know if Wikipedia can officially announce that, but they did, so I guess they can. Anyway, what harm can it do? And I probably am not getting all the omega-3s that I probably could be getting.
I hear omega-3s are really good for preventing, like, heart disease and stuff, too. All kinds of stuff.
I'm probably all right with heart disease. I don't think I do too much that's bad for my heart, but maybe they can... Maybe fish oils... And flaxseed oils can fill in the holes in my brain.
Just clump it in there.
Yeah, yeah. Just fill it up with their oily little pools. Right? Isn't that how it works?
That's how it works.
Science.
That's what Wikipedia teaches.
Plug those brain holes.
I wish that's what it said on the fish oil. Do you get the pills or do you take the little packets that you squeeze out into your mouth?
Yeah, see, I was worried about how disgusting it would be. I've never had the fish oil before. Last night I bought a big liquid thing of flax and fish oils.
And it's not pills?
It's
liquid?
No pills.
You drink it?
Both of them are liquid. Well, you mix it with stuff.
Insane.
And the fish has been mixed with stuff, so that it's not gross at all, except for...
Does it say anywhere on the package, no fish burps? Because a lot of them do say that, because
right.
People are really worried with the fish oil
exactly.
About the fish burps.
That's why it came to mind when you yep. said, oh, I burps. Fish burps.
Fish burps.
That's what everybody thinks of.
No fish burps.
Fish oil. Yeah.
Yeah.
But this, you know, it's just not like a fish at all. Like, it bears no resemblance or
doesn't look like
flavor
a
flavor or smell or look of a fish.
That was always my big problem with eating fish. That's why I could eat at McDonald's, I could eat the Filet-O-Fish, but I couldn't eat like a fish at a fancy restaurant because... The restaurant does little to prepare the food for you. They just bring you a fish
yeah.
cut in half on a plate, and you see it, and it's just sitting there.
Yeah. Who wants to look at the big dead eyes of...
I like it when a company will take the time to shred it and goo it up and build it into a patty for me.
Make it totally unrecognizable.
Yeah. I don't want to know it. I don't want to see it. I mean, I don't eat meat anymore, so I don't have to worry about it, but I appreciated yeah. about hamburgers that it did not look like a cow, because
yeah.
I don't think I would be able to eat a cow.
Yeah.
Even when I ate meat.
If it had a big dead cow head and big dead cow eyes.
Yeah, or if they somehow made a way to raise little, you know, 6-inch long mini cows or something.
You eat the whole thing.
You just would eat the whole thing.
Yeah.
Fry it up and...
Gross.
I know.
Yeah.
It's terrible.
Ugh.
I don't do it.
No, I know. Who condones the eating of these tiny 6-inch cows?
Not me.
No.
Pick on the big cows, please. Eat the big ones. Leave my 6-inch cows alone.
Jake is very protective, as he should be.
I am protective of my farm of 6-inch cows that I raise.
6-inch cows that you raise. Oh, yeah. I have this thing about
the... Oh, yeah.
I had this connected, although it's not connected to
food.
We
should play Connect 4 sometime. That reminded me of Connect 4.
I like Connect 4.
Yeah.
Let's play it.
Yeah. I don't have it. Do you have
it? Yeah.
We should get Connect 4. Yeah.
Yeah.
Connect 4.
Did you mean on the show or just in life?
Either or.
Okay.
And or both.
All right. Cool. Yeah.
Look forward to many episodes filled with Connect 4 in the very near future.
Sometimes I wear that shirt that says Connect Four.
I know. That's a good shirt.
I know. I didn't make it. I didn't make it. But it is a good shirt.
Somebody made it.
Somebody made it. I know who. I know who.
Do I know the person?
Yeah, I live with her.
Oh, okay. Makes sense.
Yeah, it was her shirt.
I've met her.
I inherit a lot of shirts from her. She doesn't want to wear them anymore. And then I can wear them.
It's a hand-me-down.
It's a handy-down. Oh, man.
All right, oh. Should we hit this list?
Yeah, we should hit it hard. Oh, my God. You're going to like this one.
Oh, dear.
Sheesh, we haven't even touched this list. We may have to put some of these off. I wrote down a lot of things.
Oh, my gosh.
All right. Today, another thing that happened today, apart from looking at some people, a couple people, just like two.
That was your day. Two.
Yeah. Okay, I watched Single White Female on TV today. I'd never seen the movie
You'll
before.
You'll have to tell me about this. I don't know what this is. Is it a movie? Is it a TV show?
It's a movie.
You'll have to start at the very bare basics for me.
Jake. 1992 film with Bridget Fonda and Jennifer Jason Lee. Is that her name?
Jennifer Jason Lee.
Jennifer. No, that doesn't sound right, does it?
I've never known a girl whose middle name is Jason, but it may have been done.
Damn it, man. Why don't you know anything?
I'll find it. I have a computer access here. I have the internet. We have the internet right here.
Anyway.
What's it called?
Damn. It's called Single White Female.
Okay. Come on!
Surprised you haven't heard about it, seeing as you love the 90s.
I love the 90s.
Anyway, it's a movie. It's a thriller. It's a thriller. Could call it a slasher movie, I guess. It's pretty mild. But I've avoided it. Not, like, strongly, but I never, ever thought I would like it. I was like, nah, why would I watch that movie? That doesn't sound appealing. That doesn't sound like a good movie. But today I watched it because, they're playing all kinds of terrible horror movies. And
You are absolutely right. Jennifer Jason Lee.
Yes! Touchdown!
Nicely done. My goodness. Oh my gosh.
Jason Lee. Lady Jason. What?
You know who is in that movie is Renee Esteves. Daughter of Martin Sheen and Janet Sheen.
Who is she in that movie?
I will tell you. She played Perfect Applicant. She played herself. Renee Esteves.
Yeah, okay. Perfect Applicant. It was a bit part. I don't know which one.
Do you remember that part?
Yeah, I do. I do remember that, actually. I know which one that was, even
now. You know what I'm talking
about. Now that I think about it, I know exactly which character that was.
That's great.
But anyway, the movie was pretty good. You know,
6.2 out of 10 on IMDb.
I know. I saw that. I looked.
Okay.
Roger Ebert gave it a very positive review, though. I mean, he doesn't like slasher movies.
He doesn't like any movies.
He likes some.
I think he liked WALL-E.
Yeah, he likes some stupid movies.
I like WALL-E.
He likes some... I've never seen WALL-E. So
oh, you would love it.
I can't
You would
comment.
Just love WALL-E.
Anyway, Single White Female, much, much better than I thought it was going to be. I liked that the villain and the hero were both female. That's unusual for horror, slasher, whatever movies, you know?
That's kind of cool.
So, yeah, that was cool. And Bridget Fonda and Lady Jason both did a nice job. I'm not familiar with either of them. I think of them as people I wouldn't watch in a movie because they don't sound like people I would like. Because I don't know why. That's just the association I have tucked in my head for some reason. But I did like them both. They did a good job. And it was a pretty good movie. And you would have loved it because it featured early 90s internet.
Oh my gosh. Was it like text-based?
Yes.
Did people log into their text-based internet browsers?
Well, probably. They didn't show the whole process, but it looks like a text document, and she's like...
I love the early 90s internet.
It was great. I was so excited when I saw that. But I guess that was all I had to say about it. I thought you would know about the movie. I thought surely you would have at least heard about it, if not seen it.
I saw on IMDb that there's a sequel.
Well, I'm not interested in the sequel.
Really? Why not?
The other day on TV, I saw My Bloody Valentine 3D in 2D.
In how does that translate?
Oh, it looks pretty silly. All the graphics are like flying at the camera and floating on top of each other. It looks pretty stupid. You could tell that they are milking that 3D technology.
I was trying to find that web browser. I thought we could show the people. Oh,
the old fashioned.
Yeah. Yeah. You but can. No. I wanted to use that browser within a normal browser. I wanted it to load for me.
But it didn't. Okay.
I'll see if I can find it.
See, I knew I'd get you hooked with that 90s.
You got me
internet.
Hooked. Now all I want to do is
all I want to do is dance.
All I want to do is dance.
So get on with it.
I'm trying. I'll work on it. We'll talk. I'll work on it.
Let's talk. Call me. Don't call me. I hate talking on the phone.
I won't call you. Don't worry.
Good. Oh, this is important.
What is it?
Well, I'm sure you, Jake, and everybody at home and on the internet watching the show, you've all heard about this new legislation trying to be passed. They're trying to pass this new legislation that would make hats for bald people only. Hats, legally, would only be
wearable. Who's trying to pass this?
Bald people. Legislators.
Of the government?
The government.
The U.S. government?
Yeah. The federal and the local government are trying to pass laws that say...
What? Are they serious?
No hats unless you are bald or balding.
What? They're... Oh, but
I like to wear a hat sometimes.
So many people wear hats.
Sometimes I like to wear a hat. Why,
yeah,
why
man. Everybody wears a hat. Everybody wears a hat. We wouldn't have that great song by whoever wrote Everybody Wears a Hat.
Yeah, men with hats.
Men with hats.
Men with hats. Hats.
Hats.
This is Hat Week on the Jubi Show.
I love Hat Week.
10th floor hat, buddy. What'd you do? What'd you do, man? What is it? That's not what it looked like.
I'm working on it.
Nice.
Clearly, I'm doing it wrong. I didn't do it right.
Oh gosh, Jake. Okay, what else?
Okay.
What else? Here we go.
Wait, what are the... When are they gonna... When is this legislation going to pass? When am I no longer going to be able to wear my hat?
Well, that's why you gotta get on the boat in the primaries. This November, vote. I mean, vote yes hats. Yes hats.
Yes hats?
Well,
can you get...
I think on the ballot it will say hat hair, because it's the law, the bill about people who have hair being able to wear hats.
Right.
And I think it will just say hat hair yes or no, and you can fill in. And you want hat hair, you want to say yes.
Hat hair?
Hat
yes.
Hair yes.
So we do want hat hair.
Yeah, well, we, the non-balding citizens of the universe, would like the privilege of being allowed to wear hats if we feel like wearing a hat on top of our head with hair.
You know, there really should be a way... there should be a word for us.
What?
Like...
What's us?
Well, us with hair.
The non-balding.
Yes. I want a word... I want something as easy to say as like baldies.
Right.
But like, they're slightly different, like baldos.
Only for hairs.
Only for hairs.
Haired.
Does that make sense?
Oh, yeah, because there's all kinds of words for baldos.
Yeah.
Like,
well, are there?
Cue ball...
Well, oh, yeah. Oh, for baldies. I'm sorry. Baldies. When you said baldos, I thought you meant for us.
I didn't realize. I got confused by your use of the word baldos, I guess. I thought baldos referred to baldies. Bald peoples. Cue balls.
cue balls. They don't call us cue balls.
Well, they can't because the hair gets in the way. What doesn't work? It doesn't work. Anyway, but we still want to wear hats sometimes.
Yeah. Maybe oh, absolutely.
Some of us do. I don't know. I can't speak for all of the hairballs. Is that what we're called?
Yeah, it's hairballs, I think.
Can't speak for all the hairballs, but a lot of us like to wear hats. A lot of them. Some of them like to wear hats a lot more than I do. A lot more often than I do. Let them. Let the hairballs wear. Let us wear our hats, cue balls. It's just not fair, and it's just not very cool of you to be like that about it. You don't own the idea. I love what you've done with the computer.
Welcome to the internet.
I love it.
Is there any way to... how do I use it? Oh, it's Go. Let's open our website.
Wow. This is cool.
It's going.
This is cool. This is not what it looked like on Single White Female, I will have you know, but...
Is this even better? Look, yeah, well, it's our website. I can hit tab and go through all of the hyperlinks.
Nice. This is kind of better in a way. It's got more colors. In the movie, it was just black and white.
I want to do a Google web search.
Yeah, okay. Do a Google web search. Okay.
What should I search for using the internet?
Look for... Okay. Type in two names in quotes.
Okay.
Okay. I want you to type in all, that's O-L, and then the apostrophe, all, dirty,
oh,
old dirty bastard. Yeah, end quotes. And then second name, begin quotes, big baby Jesus, end quotes. Let's see what comes up.
All right, I'm doing a Google search for it.
Old dirty bastard and big baby Jesus. Old school internet. Oh, we got 40,000 results.
I can't even tell what's going on. YouTube.
YouTube.
Should we watch this YouTube video?
Big baby Jesus. Love me do. Nice.
That sounds pretty good.
Yeah.
All right. We're visiting YouTube.
Looks good.
Apparently I need... Adobe Flash Player.
Oh, snap.
Why don't I browse? I'm going to use this as my primary web browser at home.
Yeah, do it.
You don't get all the gross pictures when you search for things.
Yeah, all the ads and pop-ups.
Yeah, all the ads and pop-ups.
Yeah. Speaking of gross pictures, well, one of the things that was going on, and maybe I hope this is appropriate to even talk about, but somebody was downloading gross pictures on one of the computers out there in the
really?
Lobby. Yeah.
Oh dear.
Yeah, and that's it's not cool.
That's uncouth.
Yeah.
It's pretty bad.
It's not appropriate. And you know, the least you could do if you're doing that is to delete it so nobody catches you 5 seconds later. Come on.
Or at least use the private browsing sessions that open up in a web browser.
You don't need to be downloading it to our
computer.
Yeah,
you don't need to store it locally.
Yeah, really.
That's what the internet's for, is to keep all the gross things in the internet and out of your house.
Yeah. I mean, I know they will try to download themselves onto your computer one way or another.
They do. They try to force their way onto your computer.
Yeah.
Thankfully, the internet is there to stop them.
That's right. Just be like, internet, prevent this thing on the internet from...
Stop yourself.
Stop it, internet.
Damn it.
Stop it, internet.
Stop it, internet.
That's like, send me money and I will stop myself from harming your computer
with harmful
files.
Yeah. Jeez. That happens to people, let me tell you.
Oh, man. Gosh.
What do we got next?
Well, oh, here's one.
Jordy.
I don't know if you'll feel like this. It's another movie one.
I love movies. Oh,
yeah.
I saw a movie the other day. I want to talk about it.
Oh, good. Let's talk about a movie you saw this time.
Okay. So, I went and saw a movie. Actually, I saw two movies. this weekend, but the one I want to talk about is called Drive. Have you heard of this movie, Drive?
Drive. Yeah, I mean, it rings a bell.
I've heard it billed as an insane action movie.
Is it new or not that new?
New.
It's brand new.
New.
And it's new.
It's in the theaters.
Yeah, I guess it rings a bell, but it's such a generic name.
I would recommend if you don't like being confused by movies and getting kind of bored with kind of long, boring movies
right.
that are supposed to be action movies but really only have 2 45-second car chases in them, I would recommend maybe avoiding Drive for a little while.
That sounds like a movie that I would just despise.
You would. And oh, also if you like gross things like people getting shot in the face with a shotgun, that's not bad. There's some other stuff. If you like gore, sometimes you might like this movie.
Well, sometimes I do like gore, but I do not like action movies. I don't like...
Well, this is not an action movie. Let me tell you. No matter what anybody tells you, it is not an action movie.
All right. Well, then maybe I would like it.
You would love it. You would absolutely love this movie. I know you, and you would love this movie.
No action, shotgun to the face. That sounds like me.
Yep. That does... It does sound like... There's no action.
Shotgun to the face.
Shotgun to the face. Anyway, that was my movie... That was my movie review of Drive.
Jake reviews... This week on Jubi's show, Jake reviews... Drive.
Oh, the characters were boring. I didn't care about them.
Yeah, that's a problem for a lot of movies. Is why are you supposed to even care what happens to any of these characters? Yeah.
Jeez.
Okay.
Okay, please. Okay. Go ahead. Continue. Moving right along.
With my huge list.
Have we even done two things on that list?
Oh, yeah, we have. We've done...
Are we powering through it?
We've done Single White Female in...
That was just a little sneeze for you guys.
Oh, I was trying to cover for you.
Oh, I didn't do it.
Jake was just excited about Single White Female, the movie. We talked about that. We talked about Internet of the early 90s. We talked about flax and fish liver oil. Okay, what we have not talked about here on this list. Did Stephen King invent... the twist ending for horror movies where the bad guy isn't actually dead and comes back to life at the last second.
Because wait, did he invent that?
He was talking way too much, but he was talking on Turner Classics yesterday, and I watched some of him talking.
Hi, I'm Stephen King.
I invented the entire genre.
I'm the first man to have a scary idea. I'm the original author. I wrote the first book.
He was saying that the movie Carrie...
Oh, I know Carrie.
He was saying that was the first movie to have that twist where you think the bad guy is dead.
Wait a minute, is Carrie the fire-starting movie?
No, that's Firestarter.
Is that Firestarter?
With Drew Barrymore?
Is Carrie the one with Kathy Bates?
No, that's Misery.
That's Misery. What's Carrie?
Carrie, that's a pretty old movie. That is, it's the one about she's going to prom and everybody picks on her. She's, like, not popular at school.
But can't she start fires or something?
Well... she goes all telekinetic
at
the end and starts like crushing people with their mind and
okay,
or like smashing them with the doors. I think I haven't seen the whole movie, or certainly haven't read the book, but Stephen King was saying that was the first film to use the "you think Carrie's dead and then her hand comes out of the grave at the very end."
I don't believe that.
Yeah, I can't think of anything to disprove him, but I want to, because he cannot be the first to use the dead guy isn't
dead. Can he be
the
first at anything?
No, he's never had an idea. He can't. He cannot. He was going on in this thing I saw on Turner Classics before I changed the channel. He was going on about Kubrick's The Shining and how bad it was. And, oh, he's He's not over that. He's not over...
That was like 40 years ago. Does he know that?
I know, and Kubrick's dead. He can let go of this. He made his own version. He came and made his own...
On NBC.
God-awful version.
I was only about like 10 to 15 years old at that time. Mm-hmm. I had read the book, The Shining.
Okay.
And I was surprised by how many things did not happen in the book that happened in Kubrick's The Shining.
Kubrick's. What about Stephen King's The Shining?
Stephen King's NBC's the movie The Shining, yeah. The miniseries event, had much more similarity with the book, I appreciated. Yeah. I wish it could have been a little bit more not as made for TV.
I didn't see it. I've seen like some seconds of it, and it was awful. It looked awful. I mean, just aesthetically, it looked like a piece of crap.
There were no... In the book, do you remember in Kubrick's The Shining, do you remember the hedge maze?
Right, yes.
There is no hedge maze hedge maze. There are hedge animals that do come to life.
Yeah, I knew they were... Yeah, I mean, that was one of Mr. King's complaints, was that Kubrick just went off on his own, didn't stick to that precious...
Made his own movie. Tried to make something that people who go to a movie would enjoy.
And they did, it turned out.
They liked it.
People were like, this is awesome. This is crazy cool. I love it. That's kind of how I was like. Well, the first time I tried to watch The Shining, I was a kid. Not that little, but I got too scared. I had to stop watching.
It's a scary movie.
Yeah.
The Kubrick one?
Yeah,
It's still uncomfortable to watch.
I'm okay with it now, but yeah. There are parts that make me uncomfortable, yeah. Definitely.
That guy. We should find out. We need to watch every movie and find one earlier.
Every movie before Carrie.
Because if you guys know some names of some movies that were made before Carrie, let us know, because we're going to need a list.
Give us a list of movies before Carrie. Like the original King Kong, not the remake.
Ugh.
Or Metropolis.
Oh, yeah.
Those are just to get you guys warmed up on a couple things.
Wouldn't that be bananas if they found a piece of footage from Metropolis, which was the ending where the bad guy comes back to life?
Yeah, that would be shocking. And
Stephen King would have to eat his own feet.
Yeah.
Eat his own feet.
Uh-huh. That sounds like a good Stephen King book. In this interview, Stephen King was going on about how he doesn't like the sadism and stuff in the movies. And so, who are you, Stephen King? What
have you read one of your books?
I know, I don't get it.
I've read a few Stephen King books in my day.
I believe it.
I read the book Christine. Have you read that?
I have never read any Stephen King books because
Have you seen the movie Christine?
It's a point of pride that I have to not ever read a Stephen King book.
My brain was not capable of free thinking like that to make a decision to not read Stephen King books when I read them. I was in very early high school when I read them.
Sure, sure. Well, I mean, I understand the appeal. Everybody was reading them.
Have you seen Christine?
But I don't know if I've seen all of it, but like so many of those movies, I've seen some of it, yeah.
Some bad things happen to people in those movies.
Oh, yeah, yeah. They get smashed. Some very bad things happen in almost all of his movies that I've seen. And I've seen quite a few of his.
You know what? I don't remember you saying if you liked it or not, but... What? Shawshank Redemption might be my favorite thing out of Stephen King as far as movies go.
Oh, right, right. You know, I forget that one. I remember Stand By Me, that's Stephen King, but I forget that Shawshank Redemption.
Do you remember The Green Mile?
I do remember The Green Mile, yeah. Bad things happen to people in that movie. Some really bad things happen to people in that movie.
Also, Tom Hanks pees in every movie he's in.
Yeah, we've talked about that,
and
I think.
And that does include The Green Mile.
Yeah. It's worth mentioning. I don't know what to make of it. He's got a lot of pee. That guy's got a lot of pee.
Do you think he ad-libs it?
Yeah, it's unavoidable. They can't help.
they can't stop it.
All right. Go ahead. We'll work it in. We'll fix it in post.
Oh, Tom.
Tom Cruise.
Tom Cruise.
Full of pee. Did you know, I looked it up because I was curious. I have been curious for some time now. Maybe I didn't tell you this, but the truth is, I've been curious for some time.
Oh, dear.
I looked it up.
I'm all ears.
Danny DeVito is technically short enough to be a little person.
I have seen pictures of Danny DeVito that have made me wonder that.
Yeah. I mean, he doesn't have a genetic condition, so he doesn't fit into any class of...
He doesn't have a genetic condition?
A genetic condition that inhibits bone growth or, you know, proper...
He's really short.
He's very short.
How tall is he?
Well, I read from a source that I for some reason believed. I read that he was at his tallest, he was 4'9.5". And more often he is 4'9".
I always picture him being, you know, at least 5'4".
Really?
Yeah, but I know he's not, because I've seen... I mean, in movies, they tend to do a better job making him not look so tiny.
Well, he was on, you know how he's always on Sunny in Philadelphia. He's on Sunny in Philadelphia.
I need to watch that. I hear it's amazing. Is it good?
Yeah, I mean, it's funny enough. But the last episode I saw, there were little kids on it, and it was just interesting because they were the same height he was. So that was funny.
That's comedy gold.
Yeah. They weren't playing that up or anything. It just
they should have.
To be.
I would.
Yeah, I know.
Somebody... I would typecast him as the small guy, the small fat guy.
He's not that fat, but I guess. I mean, yeah. Small, ugly. Small, ugly guy.
Small, ugly guy.
Small, ugly.
You know,
bald,
they did,
bald.
Tim Burton did in Batman Returns.
Tim Burton did what?
He cast,
oh, small,
he cast
ugly.
Him as Penguin.
Small, ugly guy, yeah. Yeah, that's right.
Tim Burton knows a small ugly guy when he sees
him. Hey, I need a small ugly guy for this movie.
Danny DeVito.
Danny DeVito. Oh, there's something
that
on
was
this
the
list.
Last movie I missed a part of the movie because I had to go out and pee during the movie.
Wait, what movie?
Batman Returns.
Whoa, that was a long time ago.
Ever since I missed part of Batman Returns, I have always made a point of going to the bathroom before the movie, no matter how little I think I have to go.
And that works.
It seems to have.
Huh.
My track record's pretty good.
Pretty good. Pretty good.
If I've seen the movie, I'll make an exception. If I've already seen it, I'll go.
Yeah.
First time, not.
You're going to sit there for every second.
Yep.
There's supposed to be all these horror movies now because it's the month of October, so there's a lot of crap
Saw
for me
19?
To watch. I don't know about that one.
Oh, you mean on TV?
On TV. There's a lot of... There's some crap for me to look at because for some reason I like to watch those terrible movies sometimes.
Right.
I don't know why.
You find some good ones, though.
Well, Single White Female was good.
Yeah.
I liked it.
Yeah.
Yes.
My Bloody Valentine 3D 2D. Not that good, but not the
worst. Would it have been better
in
3D? Did the conversion down to 2D ruin the movie? Did it wreck it?
No, I wouldn't have wanted to see all the body parts popping out.
Was it obvious that they were trying to make body parts pop out at the camera?
Oh, absolutely. A guy's jaw gets ripped off and flies right at the camera. Yep.
Weren't we talking about trying to make this show in 3D 3 years ago before this 3D thing caught on?
Probably. We probably invented the idea for 3D stuff and then they stole it, but yeah. I don't know.
I know we talked about it.
Couldn't
and that's
swear
when it,
to it.
When it kind of blew up.
Yeah, that's probably about when it blew up. Oh, yeah. I don't think we've gotten enough funding from people tonight. I think we kind of got off topic and forgot to get so much funding from everybody tonight.
We're the only people that watched our show on the internet tonight.
Yeah, I noticed that.
One lonesome viewer, and it's two of us.
Yeah. That's okay.
That's fine. I like it. You know, I like being the only one that watches the show. I feel like I'm a part of something special and that I've got something that nobody else has.
Yeah, this is private. This is private time.
Welcome to our private TV show, but not really because you can't watch it because you're not in our club.
So you aren't welcome. You're not even a little bit welcome. Please leave. You've entered our secret clubhouse.
But leave the TV on.
Leave the TV on
leave
so
the room.
We can continue.
Just leave the room. Let us have some time alone in here.
Give us a moment. What are you doing? Why do you need to watch?
Don't be such a voyeur.
Close the door and go to the other room and find something else to do for the next 5 minutes.
At the very least, drape a towel over the TV and turn it all the way down.
Mute it.
Don't turn it off, though. If you turn it off, Jake and I cease to exist.
Did that blow your little minds?
It blew their little minds.
Do you want to pull the plug on our life?
Don't. We only need 5 more minutes and we'll be saved. Just let it go.
We are on life support, so to speak. And you pulling the plug is terminating our existence.
Literally. Do you want that on your conscience? You want that?
And will you know if it happened or not? Will you even know if you did something wrong?
Will they know if they've killed us or not? Yes. I don't. That's the question, isn't it? Isn't that always?
It's like how you're not supposed to shut down your computer. You're not supposed to turn off your computer without shutting it down. Wait for the show to end naturally, and then you can turn it off.
Exactly. It's very harmful for your television and the internet and cable.
Actually, I heard you can break your computer doing or your TV doing that.
Turning our show off.
Turning our show off prematurely. Before it's done.
Yes. So wait. You've got like 3 minutes. What's
and you've got like, I see like 4 towels over there.
Just grab
one.
If it's bothering you that much, grab one of your many towels.
Throw it over our TV, our little TV screen.
You think this is easy? It's not easy doing this.
This is hard work.
Really hard work that we do.
I have to squint and grunt and push
and pull
and yell
and Pry.
That's the only way this show comes out.
Sometimes it
doesn't.
Not coming
out any other way.
Sometimes it won't even come out then.
It's in there so much.
Sometimes.
It's stuffed up there so hard. Yeah. That's an accurate representation.
It's a reenactment.
Of what we're doing, of what Jamal's doing right now. A live reenactment. What is it?
This is now a live reenactment of the Jubi Show.
Yeah.
Tonight's Jubi Show
tonight,
specifically.
Yeah. There have been others that have been similar, but not quite the same.
Well, no two are identical.
That's true. They tell you that they are.
In school, they'll tell you that they are.
Welcome to high school.
I adopted again. Oh, it's upside down. Now,
oh, no.
Now it's just my grocery list. Now it's just a grocery list.
You bought one.
That's a joke.
Oh.
It's a joke that sometimes I tell it and people don't seem to think it's funny. It's not my joke, but I think it's funny. It's Harris. I don't know his last name. L.A. Harris. His joke. And I'll say it right now.
Tell me the joke.
You know.
I demand it.
Hey.
What?
You know, half and half creamer? Why don't they just call it one?
That is a good joke.
That's a good joke,
they
right?
They should.
Yeah.
And skin milk. They should just...
Skin milk.
It should just be called skin milk.
Skin milk.
They insist on the M to rate it so the children can read it.
Is that what it is about?
Yeah.
It's all the politics.
Yep, politics. Skin milk.
Smorgasbord.
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 What is a smorgasbord?
As a German person. That's Swedish, but it's close.
Yeah.
Close.
It's kind of October. It kind of got a little Oktoberfest-y in here, didn't it?
October, yeah.
October. I'm going to find out what a smorgasbord is. Ooh. How do you spell smorgasbord?
S-H-T-M-O-C-H-T? O B O R G
Did you mean stomach tube? Really, Schmucktobo.
Schmucktobo.
Schmocktobo. Smorgasbord. A smorgasbord is a type of Scandinavian meal served buffet style with multiple dishes of various foods on a table. The table originates in Sweden. In Norway, it is called koldbord.
Koldbord.
In Denmark, it is called det koldbord.
Koldbord.
In Estonia, it's called rutsilaud.
Rutsilaud. Borgi, 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 borgi.